Even more interesting.
I would love to be on a stage with some of these scientists, okay?
What about on a podcast? Like, one of the things that I understand this is going to be a very controversial podcast, and your book is controversial. I would like to get someone to come on opposite of you next and either by themselves first and then you with them together, or depending upon their what they would like.
I would certainly be up for that, but let me tell you what you should do. Have somebody else on, and you can have them say where that guy Koonen is wrong, but then have them write it down, okay? You really, if you're going to do a scientific discussion, debate, you got to put it in writing. Okay, you can't call names, and you can't say, okay.
Have you debated anyone about this?
So I have not debated anybody about this. Actually, I take it back. I debated this person, Richard Lindzen, in 2010. My feeling is that I won't debate the science. So the science is set. You know, temperature's warming, humans are the cause. I'm happy to debate policy because I think policy needs to be debated. So if someone wants to debate energy policy with me...
Why wouldn't you debate the science?
Because the science has already been debated in the scientific system.
I understand that. But to the average person that gets confused and doesn't know whether or not you're correct or Steve Koonen is correct...
Yeah, so I think...
A debate would be very beneficial.
I disagree with that entirely. Because,
how so?
Because in a one-on-one debate, without the ability to fact-check people... So let's
say... Why couldn't you fact-check them in real life?
In real time. Real time. Yeah, because, real time. How do I do that? He says, this paper says this. And I'm saying, do you want me to read the paper?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it would be a debate that would take a week.
So we'd do a week.